23, LeBron
Welcome back. Thank you for checking out this edition of the 12 Kyle podcast. I'm 12 Kyle. Check this out. On this episode, my man King Jerm from the Frocast podcast stops by. And we're going to have a little goat talk. That's right. We're talking about LeBron James and Michael Jordan. Now, King Jerm is going to speak for LeBron James. And I, of course, will be speaking for Michael Jeffrey Jordan. Now, during the podcast, I forgot to mention to King Jerm about how feared Michael Jordan was. Like, his opponents were shook before they even stepped on the basketball court. And conversely, nobody fears LeBron. Listen, folks, the jokes will fly, the stats will fly, but the numbers don't lie. So after the break, what you will hear, MJ. LeBron, Goat Talk, King Jerm, 12 Kyle, right here on the 12 Kyle podcast. Let's get it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for listening. Thank you for downloading. And thank you for subscribing to the latest edition of the 12 Kyle podcast. I'm 12 Kyle. Check this out. On this podcast, we are going to make an attempt to settle the age-old debate. We're talking goat talk. And we're talking about Michael Jeffrey Jordan and LeBron James. And when I say goat, I mean, that's an acronym for those of you who may not know, for the greatest of all time. Now, let me just be honest. There's really no way of settling an argument about who's the greatest of all time because what's the criteria? Well, on this episode, we're going to make an attempt, or at least to entertain you and entertain ourselves and keep it funny. And I will not be doing this show alone. You see it, you clicked on it, you know who's here. Friend of the show, one half of the almighty Frocast podcast, my man King Jerm is in the building. Jerm, what up?
What's going on, people? It's your boy King Jerm, aka the People's Champion, back over here in 12 Cow Studios. And yes, the catfish is still delicious.
You stupid. What's going on, man?
Hey man, what's going on, man? I finally got you to sit down with me and have this debate, man. I've been getting at you for a while, letting you know that LeBron is the GOAT. And now we're gonna lay out the facts on the tables for the people today, and we're gonna let them decide. But I think people are going to understand LeBron is the GOAT after this.
Well, we'll see. We'll see. So just for you listening, for those of you listening, how we came to this, it's interesting because on the Frocast, King Jerm recently did a podcast episode where they talked about the NBA did their 75 greatest players of all time list. And obviously, you know, LeBron James and Michael Jordan made the list. And lo and behold, one day, not too long after that podcast was released, I get a text message on the old iPhone, and I look up and it says King Jerm. I start reading, and the text message said something to the effect of, "Are you ready to admit that LeBron is better than Jordan?" And I said, "Oh, hell no." And what was interesting was I was actually going to do an episode for my boys on Dead End Sports talking about that. Just a short, you know, video for YouTube. I was going to do something about, you know, some comments that had been made here recently. And lo and behold, my man Jerm hits me up and asks about it. So I was like, man, this is perfect. I said, we can do it. I was like, you want to do a podcast on this? And Jerm said, yeah, he wanted to do a podcast on it. So I warned Jerm. I said, hey, Jerm, I don't want to embarrass you. I'm not going to jeopardize our friendship, but I do want to let you know that, you know, facts will be laid out. Okay. And, you know, that's how it's going to go. So that's how we got to this this episode. What actually spawned my thought process in doing the video that, you know, like I said, is probably not going to come out now. But in lieu of the video, we have this podcast right before the All-Star game earlier this calendar year in 2020. At the time of this recording, LeBron James did an interview with Kenny Smith from TNT. And in the interview, he said, quote, at that moment, I was like, I'm the greatest basketball player people have ever seen, doing something that has never been done before in the history of the sport. Close quote. So that's how we got here. I was going to talk about how LeBron just said, because he beat his team beat the 73-9 Warriors, that he's the greatest of all time. So anyway, so this is how it's going to go. We're going to talk. We're going to go back and forth, and each of us will lay out a case for why, you know, this one is or isn't the GOAT. So that's the backstory. So now, with that being said, King Jerm, I'm assuming that you have, if you have LeBron at one, you have Jordan at two, correct?
Yes, Jordan is definitely number two. Now, okay. Before we get into this, before we get into this, I want everyone to know, Michael Jordan is my favorite player of all time, but I think LeBron is better than Michael Jordan. Okay. I just want everybody to know that.
And for the record, Jerm, you are 41, correct? 43. Oh, okay. So. Yeah. For those of you scoring at home, okay, Jerm is 43. I'm 49. So both of us saw Michael Jeffrey Jordan in his prime. You know, we're not like some of you little YouTubers and little farting, little squirt guys, young Thundercats who listen to Lil Baby and and think everything is the greatest thing since sliced bread. We've seen LeBron since day one. We've seen Jordan since day one. So context matters. Okay, so with that being said, King Jerm, give me your reasons, and you can lay them out. You know, I sent you a format I wanted, like 1 through 5, and feel free to expound as much as you want upon them. Case for Jordan being number two as far as GOATs.
All right, well, we're going to start it from the top. Number one, the number one reason why I think Jordan is a step below LeBron James is because he was a ball hog and he ushered in the era of me first basketball. Now, Michael Jordan did a lot for the game, but his most damaging effect of the game was the ISO. He turned into people that want to shoot up 50, 60 shots a game. It birthed the AIs, the James Hardens, the Kobe Bryants, all of those great players, but they love to shoot the ball too much. And that was one thing Michael Jordan, he kind of took away from the essence of basketball because, hey, they didn't even have an illegal zone that they had to call against Jordan because they would basically just move all the guys out to the wing and let him play two-on-two basketball just to, I mean, basically that's what it was. So that's one of the reasons why I got a case for him being number two. Number two, he had Pippen and Phil Jackson. Those guys right there, great base to have. He always had a better team. Every time he went to the finals, he was the better team. No competition. Michael Jordan ran the gamut. It seemed like the NBA was set for him to be so successful. Number three, he was a freak of nature at that time. Michael Jordan was a freak. 6'6", 195 pounds. He was a freak of nature. Michael Jordan would be DeMar DeRozan in today's game. Physically, that's all I'm saying, people, physically. Nothing special about DeMar DeRozan when you got Greek freaks, KDs, and all these seven-footers that can shoot threes. Michael Jordan wouldn't be, in today's game, you know. Number four, he was a terrible teammate. All he cared about was winning. He didn't care about your families. Michael didn't show up to none of your events. He beat up his teammates. I mean, he just didn't. He berated them. Look what he did to poor Scott Burrell, man. Terrible teammate. Terrible teammate. And my last reason, he had more losing seasons than LeBron. If you look at Michael Jordan's record, you take Scottie Pippen out of the equation, Michael Jordan has a losing record every season that Scottie Pippen didn't play. The season without Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen played, he won 57 games. So, you know, the team was pretty good. They won 63 the year before with Jordan. They won 57 without Jordan. So that let me know that it was a pretty damn good team, and the difference of Jordan was 6 games and a championship. That's not, you know, 6 games and a championship. And Jordan basically was a stat stuffer. I can score 63 points if I take 56 shots a game. I'm pretty confident in that. If I take 56 shots, I can score 63. And for all you people out there that's going to say, what about that game against the Celtics where he scored 63? He lost that game. He lost that game, okay? It was the same thing as AI shaking Michael. He lost that game. So those are my reasons why I think Jordan is just a step below LeBron.
Okay. Very interesting. I wrote a few things down, but I'll circle back to that later.
Okay.
Here's my case for LeBron being number two. Now, let me start by saying that I absolutely love LeBron James. I love watching him play. LeBron James, unlike Michael Jordan, is somebody that I, 12 Kyle, would want to hang out with. LeBron seems like a cool guy to hang out with. As much as I love Jordan, there's no way in hell I'd hang out with Jordan. Because Jordan, you know, I'll get into his personality later. But no, LeBron, so I want to preface that by saying, because I want people to understand that I'm not a hater. I love LeBron James. I love watching him play. I have followed him and have enjoyed watching his ascension from the first time that I saw him on ESPN when he was in high school at St. Mary's High School in Akron, Ohio. That being said, because I wanted to preface that, because I don't want anybody to miss what I'm about to say behind this. You know, you got to give the good before you give bad. You know what I'm saying, King Jerm? So, yeah, I love LeBron. Not a hater at all. And just like you prefaced your comment by saying that, you know, Jordan was your favorite basketball player, LeBron is one of my favorite players to watch. But LeBron is number two. Here's a point. LeBron, to his credit, has lived up to the hype. And then some. LeBron was, you know, from, as I mentioned, probably since the time he was 10 years old, or let's say 15, 16, he was expected to be the second coming. And he graced the cover of Sports Illustrated when he was in high school. He was drafted number one. And, you know, he had all of these expectations. And not only did he live up to the expectations, he exceeded the expectations. I don't think that there's anybody that's ever come out of high school that had that kind of hype and had that kind of expectation. I know some may say, well, Kobe, but Kobe didn't have, if you were around in 96, you know, Kobe had expectations, but his expectations weren't to be the next one. That became over a period of time. LeBron was, you know, he was indoctrined to be the next great NBA player. And I mean, I think his first game as an NBA player, I think he scored like 20 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists or something like that. It's crazy. And so, you know, all the way up from the time that he was 15, 16 years old until the time he was, until now, he has lived up to the hype. So, you know, I can make a case that I'm using this to make a case that he's number two. Second point, LeBron was dominant on and off the court. And he did it in an era where there was so many distractions. You have social media. You know, LeBron never had any off the court issues. You know, don't have no side kids. Don't have no side chicks. You know, he never got in trouble with the law. You could make a case that his worst mistake publicly was the decision. And the decision really wasn't a mistake in my mind, because at the time he was a free agent. So he was free to go wherever he wanted to go. The problem I had with the decision was he could have not done the whole press conference thing and left people hanging. But, you know, LeBron tends to be very passive aggressive, and he does some, you know, borderline Herb stuff. But and that was one of them, you know, because he literally left his teammates hanging because nobody knew what he was going to do that night. But nonetheless, I think the decision wasn't, if he had a chance to do it all over again, I'm sure he would have done it differently, because he could have just let his agent say, hey, he's going to Miami. He didn't have to have a whole TV show for an hour saying, you know, I'm taking my talents to South Beach. The knock on LeBron is that he made it cool for stars to team up. Prior to that, you know, you just got drafted where you got drafted. And the knock on LeBron for making it cool for stars to team up is that it's not that great players don't play together, but LeBron James left Cleveland to go to Miami to play with Dwayne Wade and Chris Bosh. History would view him differently if he had gotten Dwayne Wade and Chris Bosh to come to Cleveland. Well, Wade was already in Miami, so Wade wasn't going anywhere. So it's like, I can't be the man here, so let me go someplace else. Now, to his credit, he was a free agent, so there's that. But the flip side of it was he made it cool for stars to go leave teams and go here and team up, and that's what we see in the NBA today. Some people are cool with that. I think it's kind of corny, but, you know, it is what it is. Third point, I have always said this, and I will continue to say it. I think LeBron James off the court is the GOAT. Not on the court, but off the court. From his philanthropy and opening of the school that he did, the charter school, scholarships, and then the way that he led the charge as far as social justice, speaking out on social media about social issues, standing up. You know, we know what he did with when he was with Miami, when Trayvon Martin was killed. LeBron has always been a voice. We're in an era where athletes weren't encouraged to speak out. He always did, and he always had something to say. And normally it was something good and something positive. I mean, he called, you know, the leader of free world a bum, which I thought was dope. So off the court, when you compare LeBron and Mike, I don't think it's even close. I think LeBron, if he has one feather in his cap over Mike, it's the fact that off the court, he's done way more than Michael Jordan has ever done or ever will do. So I'll give him that. Fourth point, statistically, when it's all said and done, LeBron James will probably lead the NBA in every major statistical category. So he gets props for that. He's going to play till he's what, in his 21st year, whatever like that. So 60s. So he'll probably lead the NBA in every major statistical category. And I think that right there is going to have some people say, you know what, he's worthy of being the GOAT. Not for me. I'm going to put him at 2 for that. And the fifth, it's obvious, 4 championships. 4 championships, 6 losses. Now, he's been to the finals 10 times, but I don't know, Jerm. I wasn't really that good at math in school, but if you get 4 out of 10 right, that's a 40%. So a 40 is a failing grade. Now, we're not calling
baseball. In baseball, you the MVP.
Yes. You're right. And I'm not calling LeBron a failure, because he has done more than enough as far as success. But 4 championships in 10 attempts, not going to cut it. And more specifically, Game 4 against the Dallas Mavericks in the finals. Oh my God. if there's anything that we can point to and say Jordan never did that, LeBron James in a finals game scored 8 points more than me and you, King Jerm. Amen. He disappeared in that game, and we don't know why. Well, let me take that back. The streets. The streets know why. Something to do with his mother and one of his teammates. I'll let you fill in the blanks. I mean, look it up. Shout out to Gloria James. So, but anyway, and yeah, I guess if you found out that one of your teammates was sleeping with your mother, allegedly, you know, would that cause you to go into a funk before the biggest game of your life? Maybe, you know, I mean, maybe the killer in you would come out. Who knows? But no, my fifth and final point, game four against the Dallas Mavericks, where he scored 8 points. He was lethargic. Literally, he was just out there. If you ever want to see, and of course, we'll never see that LeBron again, but he was like, in some people's eyes, he'll never be the GOAT just for that. That's a major knock against him. So those are my 4 points for, excuse me, my 5 points for LeBron being number two. Now, Jerm, I'm going to flip it back to you. Make your case for why LeBron is the GOAT. He's number one.
I'm getting my eclectic shit real quick. I mean, you just made my case for me why he's number one. You know what I'm saying?
The disappearing in game four?
Oh, I mean that four out of your five picks. I mean, excuse me, topics. I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Basically, we're saying like LeBron's the GOAT. You say he's gonna have every statistical category. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I was like, dang, did 12 Cal steal my notes? So I'm sitting there like, wow, I said everything I was gonna say. But
hey, you saw that movie 8 Mile, right?
Okay, I must say what Eminem did.
He said everything before dude said was gonna say it. So, hey.
I mean, so dang. Well, I mean, my first point why I think LeBron Raymond James is the GOAT. One, longevity. We have never seen a player play this long and stay in the top 10 players in the league for this long. Never seen before in any sport. I don't think there is a sport alone where we have a player that participated for 18 plus years and we're at the top of the league at least 18 of those years. Like, it's amazing. Amazing. So the longevity of LeBron, the fact that he's 37 years old right now and they still want him to carry the load. Most players, when they're 37, they taking pictures in cars looking drunk with cheese eyes, you know what I'm saying? Or they're sitting on the bench, you know what I'm saying? Or they're coming back from retirement just to take over a team that they bought in and they're the owner in. So they're like, yo, we got to get ticket sales up. What are you going to do? I'm going to play. But you're 40. No, I'm going to play. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and ruin the chemistry of the team. We ain't going to talk about that guy. So the longevity of LeBron is another reason why he's a GOAT. Second reason, I do believe, he did more with less. LeBron has never had a real coach. He's never. Every coach he's had, he has been the coach of the team. Mike Brown looked like he ran a soul food restaurant. the guy that's in Miami now, they call a great coach. This man was taping ankles and getting towels and stuff before LeBron came. Tyronn Lue, self-explanatory. Frank Vogel just got it legitimized with the bubble championship. LeBron has never had a good coach, and it showed. I think the only good coach he ever had was this dude named Coach K. You might have heard of him, won a lot of games, but he coached in the Olympics. That's the only, and then it was something about he respected them, and we saw a better LeBron. So I really think if LeBron had a better coach, he could have even been greater. Like, if LeBron played with Popovich or Phil Jackson, we wouldn't even be having this conversation. 12 Kyle would be on my side. You know what I'm saying? And then he also, he's never been, out of his 10 final appearances, he's only been the better team three times. Three times. So, and out of those three, he won two of them. So, if you really want to count it, LeBron is 2-1 in the finals.
Nah, that's not how it works, bro.
Because the other seven times, he's been the underdog seven times.
It don't matter.
It does. That means that I just got – look, he took guys like Anderson Varejao, Keisha Cole's husband.
Booby Gibson.
Yes, Booby Gibson. I didn't want to call him Booby Miles. That was on my tongue. See, his name don't even – yes. And so he took bums to the finals. Like, he carried teams. You mentioned this team in Miami. The first year, that was the only year Dwayne Wade played. That the rest of the time, LeBron was carrying everybody on his back. Thank God he was on HGH, allegedly. But he needed it to carry all those people around. And my third point is he changed the dynamics of the NBA. And what I mean by that is Michael Jordan was a company man. Okay, LeBron James was a visionary. He told the players, like, listen, we're the big ticket. You control your own destiny. You don't have to sign a 10-year deal. Sign a 2-year deal in this city. If you don't like it, leave. He changed the player-owner dynamic, and they hate him for that. And thank God he did it, because we know Michael Jeffrey Jordan wouldn't have done that. He would have kept his mouth closed and kept getting his little $2.1 million he was getting, because he know he ain't care about the NBA money, he ain't care about nobody else's money, but LeBron cares about your money, players. And so that's another reason why he's great. Reason number four, he delivered on the hype. As 12 Cal told you earlier, we have never seen, I think the only person that had more hype in their, almost as more hype in their sport was Tiger Woods. Other than that,
okay,
nobody else had this much hype on their shoulders coming into a sport, and LeBron James delivered. I knew he was for real. They came to my town. They was playing our number one school in our town, and LeBron James was 6'7", 6'8" at the time. Their center had to guard LeBron. LeBron was blowing right by this guy, dunking. LeBron had about 36 that day. And I was just like, okay, this guy's legit. Like, he really showed up. And that's been his motto. Ever since LeBron, we heard about LeBron, he's done nothing but deliver. Everybody mentions the 10 championship appearances, but I think you got to get to the championship to play to win the championship. So him getting there is the story of the NBA. He has carried the NBA the past 15 years. When Kobe stuff happened, and then LeBron, it's been a LeBron story, the quest. He's the Lord of the Rings. The quest of him getting the rings, that's why we tune in. Last year, there was no LeBron in the playoffs. Lowest ratings in a long time. Lowest ratings. Because we knew we didn't get to see the quest of LeBron. We knew we weren't getting to see it. All his LeBron fans was like, who's watching the playoffs? I can't even tell you who won the title last year. Don't even know. And then my last
reason. That would be Milwaukee, sir.
Oh, see, look, you just making up stuff now. 12 o'clock talking about the Milwaukee Bucks won the title. Yeah, right. Man, come on. Milwaukee Bucks? Glenn Robinson? Mm-mm. Big Hog and all them?
They got a guy named Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Oh, the freak. Okay, yeah, all right. Yeah. I Google it when we get off the show. 12 o'clock trying to pull fast on people. And my last reason why LeBron is greater than Jordan, two words. Savannah James. I rest my case.
Oh, you mean because he had a woman?
A black woman. The woman that's been down with him from day one. You know, he's not a philanderer. He doesn't have a girlfriend in every city. He didn't leave. You know, he just wasn't that guy. You know what I'm saying?
Mike LeBron was a Rolling James. Stone, man.
Hey, I'm just saying. That's another reason. Hey, you might... Jordan might would have been a better player if he had his mind on basketball instead of all the women he was juggling. That's all I'm saying. And then again, Michael Jordan was all about propaganda, man. They perched him up like Mike. It's drawn in our heads, us older people that saw Michael Jordan play. Like, for some reason, he has a crush on us that we can't let go. I'm one of the first ones to say, you know what? I can love Jordan and admit LeBron was better. If y'all older people are saying this, the game of basketball is not going to evolve past Michael Jordan, y'all are crazy. Okay, so what y'all saying is there's never going to be a greater player than Michael Jordan. Is that what y'all saying? Unbelievable. That person's here now. His name is LeBron James. So listen, all y'all Jordan fans, it's okay to say Jordan's your favorite player, but you got to admit that LeBron James is better. I didn't even want to bring up stats. I was like, you know what? The stat game don't even matter because y'all going
to
throw up.
You don't want to go that route.
Hey, listen. I know LeBron got more points, rebounds, assists, probably steals now. You know what I'm saying? I mean, what else you want? I mean, that's the game.
I already said he's gonna be ahead of Jordan he's already ahead in points, so he's probably gonna be ahead in all major statistical categories, which would happen if you play 20 years.
I mean, a lot of people play 20 years and didn't eclipse that. It's only a couple names up there, you know what I'm saying, that played 20. Mm-hmm. I mean, hey, Michael wouldn't have been a quitter, you know what I'm saying? He might could have played 20 years. But, hey, that's another story for another day, you know. Yeah, but I rest my case, man. LeBron James is the GOAT, man.
Okay. So eloquently put. I think you missed a few things here, my friend. So let me help you. Okay. Michael Jeffrey Jordan is the GOAT. One, he was a superior scorer, more so than brother James. Scoring titles. LeBron has one. Jordan, 10. Mike averaged King Jerm 30 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists while shooting 83% from the free throw line. Now, yeah, LeBron shoots 3-pointers at a little bit higher clip, but Jordan was in an era where they didn't really shoot a lot of 3-pointers. Yeah, I mean, Larry Bird only averaged like 4 3-pointers a game. Steph Curry might get up.
I don't think he averaged 4. He might average like 2.
Right. So and Steph Curry do that in a quarter.
He averages 12 a game attempts.
So exactly. So that's one thing. More importantly, number 2, Michael Jordan dominated basketball in a tougher era of basketball. And what I mean by that is that like that era was so tough. Like those of you listening, when you watch a game, you know, on TNT or ESPN, and a guy goes to the basket and he gets slapped across the face inadvertently. Oh, we got to go to the replay. That might be a flagrant foul. That wasn't a flagrant foul in the 80s and 90s when Jordan dominated. You had to get clotheslined and get your neck damn near taken off for somebody to be, you know, get hit with a flagrant foul. So hard fouls were common. Also, hand checking. You could hand check someone. So for all of you hoopers out there, hand checking means that you could put your hand on someone's hip and basically as a defender, guide them wherever you wanted them to go. There's no hand checking in the NBA as of today. If Michael Jeffrey Jordan played in today's NBA, I mean, keep in mind, he averaged 30 points.
Playing against plumbers and construction workers, hey, man, and dudes that smoke cigarettes against at some, halftime.
He played against Hall of Famers and thugs. So, I mean, you call it what you want. These little
I'm sorry to interrupt your time. I'm sorry. But we got guys out there that spend millions of dollars a year on their body. And you're talking about a guy like Vinnie Johnson that was smoking Newport 100s at halftime.
These dudes spend millions of dollars on their bodies because they – what else – you know why they spend millions of dollars on their bodies? So they can put on funny-looking clothes and walk to the locker room. All they want to do is get caught on TV walking to the locker room before the game. Second point, again, tougher era, hand checks. There was no such thing as zones. I mean, the vaunted Detroit Pistons created something called the Jordan rules. They had their own defense for Michael Jordan. So yeah, he dominated basketball and he kept Hall of Famers like Patrick Ewing, like John Stockton and Karl Malone, Charles Barkley. He kept Hall of Famers out from getting rings. Third point, Mike was the ultimate competitor. Mike was cutthroat, man. Mike would cut your heart out, throw it on the ground, do the A-Town stomp on it. And then hand it back to you. You know, one thing that LeBron has always been knocked for is a killer instinct. We know that Michael Jordan had a killer instinct. For those of you who got a chance to see the Last Dance documentary, that really showed a lot about Michael Jordan.
People were afraid of him. We were his teammates and we were afraid of him. And there was just fear.
That's why when I threw it to you. I just threw it to you.
Ignore this guy. He's come through, but he's overplayed.
The fear factor of MJ was so, so thick.
Yeah, let's not get it wrong. He was a jerk. He crossed the line numerous times. But as time goes on and you think back about what he was actually trying to accomplish, you're like, yeah, he was a hell of a teammate.
He was pushing us all to be better because he wanted to win. And guess what? It worked.
We kind of needed that, you know what I'm saying? I needed him to be the bad guy, the tough guy.
Now, one thing it did show was that Jordan's an asshole. And I mentioned this a little earlier. He's not the type of person you want to hang out with. Now, Jordan has his friends, but would 12 Kyle hang out with him? Nope. Would King Jerm hang out with him? Nope. No, Jordan was an asshole, but he was lovable. He was a lovable asshole. I mean, like, Jordan, he smoked, he drank, he gambled, he had side women, had, you know, paid for abortions. I mean, like, he did all the stuff that your drunk uncles do. That's why he's loved. So Jordan is the man. Mike was ghetto. Let's just call it what it is. Mike was ghetto. And it was lovable. I mean, and people still wanted to, you know, and here's the great thing about that era is that, again, contrary to like what LeBron did, Mike did all his dirt and we didn't know about it. I mean, we knew of some of it, but we didn't know a lot of it. We didn't know about. We found out about it later. And I might as well state the obvious. This man won 3 consecutive championships, retired for a couple of years, came back and won 3 consecutive championships again. Only a GOAT could do that. So yeah, 4th point. Everybody wanted to be like Mike. I mean, the commercials. Come on, man. I mean, who else? Nobody had dope commercials. Everybody wanted to be like Mike, but couldn't be like Mike or beat Mike. That was the thing, man. That was the thing. Everybody drank Gatorade. And
except Isaiah.
King Jerm, I'm going to ask you a quick question in the middle of my statement here.
Okay.
I know you wear sneakers. How many pair of LeBrons you got?
Oh, man, I got every LeBron sneaker that's came out.
And we know for a fact that that's not true. And this man, I'm pretty sure King Jerm owns more Jordans than I do.
No, I only got like 4 pair of Jordans.
Oh, my gosh. We need to get Queen Jerm on here.
The difference is Michael Jordan made his shoes for style. LeBron made his shoes to actually hoop in. They're not made for style.
Those shoes are ugly and they're heavy. Oh, man, those shoes feel like, let me tell you something. I've had Timberlands that have been lighter than those than LeBron's. LeBron's shoes are ugly and they're heavy. Hey, but I'm not ladies and gentlemen,
guy. I wear Brooks.
Most of you listening have never purchased a pair of LeBron James' sneakers. Almost all of you listening have purchased some Jordans. In fact, King Jerm and I did a podcast on Jordans. King Jerm didn't hit me up and say, hey, let's do a podcast on LeBrons.
We should do one. We could do one on LeBrons.
No, we can't because nobody buys those sneakers. hell, LeBron kids don't even wear them damn sneakers. Oh, and last but not least, I mean, 6 titles, 6 MVPs. I mean, I don't know what else to tell you. I mean, my man King Jerm earlier said, he said LeBron didn't play with anybody. I mean, LeBron, I'm looking at the list here. LeBron played with, let me count them up. Hold on. Let's go to the tape. Scottie Pippen, Dennis Rodman are 2 Hall of Famers that Michael Jordan played with. He also played with Artis Gilmore for a season. And I don't even know if Artis Gilmore is in the Hall of Fame.
Iceman make it? Gervin didn't make it?
He didn't play with Gervin.
He did. Gervin was his rookie, I believe.
No, he did not. Gervin played with the Spurs. Jordan played with the Bulls. If he played with the Bulls, it was before Jordan got there in 84. Okay. So Artis Gilmore, he played with a season, and Robert Chief Parrish, he played with a season. And both of them were beyond washed when they played because they only played a season. But those are the only Hall of Famers. And I'm doing this without looking up if Artis Gilmore is a Hall of Famer. I think Chief Parrish is a Hall of Famer. Let's look at LeBron James's Hall of Fame. Let's see. He's got Dwayne Wade, Chris Bosh, Kyrie Irving is probably going to be a Hall of Famer. Kevin Love's probably going to be a Hall of Famer. Shaquille O'Neal is a Hall of Famer.
And Kevin Love Anthony Davis.
Who?
Kevin Love's not going to
Hall of Fame. Kevin Love's white. He's going to the Hall of Fame, Jerm. Stop it. Anthony Davis, he's in the top 75, so he's probably going to the Hall of Fame. And Dwight Howard, definitely going to the Hall of Fame. So let's see. That's 1, 2, 3. Oh, I forgot about Russ. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Hall of Famers to Jordan's 3 in a possible. And I'll let you in on a little secret too, King Jerm. Michael Jordan only played with one other teammate that made the All-Star team.
Scottie Pippen. And Ron Harper.
Harp didn't make the All-Star team by the time he played with the Bulls.
He was a former All-Star.
I'm talking about a current All-Star.
So Rodman wasn't an All-Star when he played with the Bulls.
Rodman didn't make the All-Star team, no.
Wow. How did Dennis Rodman not make an All-Star team? If he did
not make it with the Bulls. So that's the thing. So I just read off to you now all of these. I think almost everybody.
And George Gervin played for the Bulls in 85, 86. But,
Oh, did he?
Yeah, I knew I went crazy.
I think he might have been on cocaine then. My bad.
That was the year before he got on coke.
But yeah, so, and then you got a list of these also. So LeBron played with, you know, there's always this thing that, you know, oh, you know, LeBron, he ain't had no help. He's relaxed. He's played with all-stars. He's played with future Hall of Famers. He's had better teams. He's had better teammates than Michael Jordan has. Michael Jordan played with Craig Hodges and Bill Cartwright. I mean, and drug those dudes to the title. But again, King Jerm, I mean, what can I say, man? 6 titles, 6 MVPs. I mean, bruh, I'm talking about somebody who won the Defensive Player of the Year. LeBron never won a Defensive Player of the Year. You do know that, right?
Yes, I do know. But
so, I mean, like, Jordan did it on both ends of the court.
Again, because he was a freak of nature with a bunch of plumbers and congressmen. it's hard. LeBron, look, they have defensive specialists in the game now. Like, there's no way LeBron can win Defensive Player of the Year. No way.
Because he didn't play defense like that.
He's on all defensive teams, though. He got 9 all defensive teams. Like, come on, he plays defense.
So he made 9 off. No. LeBron made 6 all defensive teams.
Okay, 6. Jordan made 9.
Jordan made 9. So 9 is more than 6.
Of course. Again, the level of competition. You can only play who's in your era. But we can look down on the era. Like, if y'all go, we can look down on the era and say these guys are not as athletic as these guys. That's all I'm saying. Like, we got freaks out there. Like, real, I said, freaks. Thugs, we got mutants.
Thugs and goons.
That didn't make them good basketball. That's why they got rid of it. The NBA was a fledgling league at that point, too. They was like, yo, we got to do something about
this. I'm glad that you mentioned that, because King Jerm, unlike you, I started watching the NBA in 1980, right? Mm-hmm. When I started watching the NBA, the games were on tape delay. And for those of you listening who don't understand what tape delay means, is that the games weren't being shown live. So, like, I would literally be watching the 6 o'clock news on CBS in my hometown of Florence, South Carolina, right? And when the sports time would come on, I would literally leave the room so that, because I knew that they were going to show the score of the Boston-Philly game, and that was the game that was going to come on. So I would leave the room and not hear the broadcast so it would not be spoiled. And after the 6 o'clock evening news went off, I would sit and watch Boston versus, you know, the 76ers, Dr. J versus Larry Bird. I would watch that. So it wasn't until
TVs back then, I used to listen to it on the radio. Stop it.
So all I'm saying is that Magic Johnson's arrival, Larry Bird's arrival, saved the NBA, right? And then in 1984, a kid out of North Carolina, University of North Carolina, came in and took it to the next level, made the game global. And that was Michael Jeffrey Jordan. So, you know, again, LeBron had 4 MVPs. LeBron had 4 MVPs, league MVPs. Jordan had 5. LeBron's 4 NBA final MVPs. And, of course, Jordan's 6 Finals MVPs. Mm-hmm. And of course LeBron's played longer, so he's made more All-Star games, and they both were Rookie of the Year. So there's nothing wrong with being number 2, King Jerm. That's all I'm saying. There's nothing wrong being number two.
That's what you need to tell Michael Jordan.
There's nothing wrong being number two. Nothing wrong at all.
He was a great player before Michael Jordan. It was a great player before that player before Michael Jordan. Like, you know, some people think Magic Johnson is a GOAT. Dr. J, Kareem. Like, it was always a great player. It's just called evolution, people. The game can't stop because Michael Jordan.
No, he's LeBron took it to the next level. He took it and made it better. I give him his prop. Yes. Yeah, He did. He took it to the next level from where Jordan did, but that does not make him the GOAT. And here's my only issue of some issues, besides LeBron being extremely passive aggressive. Here's the issue I have with LeBron. And I mentioned that at the top of this podcast, and I will repeat it. He told Kenny Smith that he was the greatest because he beat the, 73-9. Golden State Warriors. And don't get me wrong, phenomenal accomplishment. I mean, it doesn't help his case that he came and got smoked, the next 2 years by the Warriors, even though they did pick up KD. But
yeah, they went tooled up. They were 73-9.
It don't matter. If you the GOAT, then you're going to beat him again.
Hey, he did his best. I mean, he didn't do nothing but average but a triple-double in all these.
Smoked.
It's not because of him. It's because of his help.
Hey, man. Hey, oh, okay. Because this, and now all of a sudden, he don't have help.
He don't. I said that.
Y'all can't have it both ways, sir.
It's the truth. That's the thing. LeBron is the most unselfish player. He always makes – see, he gets knocked for making the smart basketball play, a play where Michael Jordan would have four people hanging on him, the coach, everybody on the crowd.
Because he's a killer.
Michael Jordan is going to take that. He's going to take that shot.
Right, he's going and Kobe's going to take that shot. And
Kobe's
AI's
going to
take
that shot. Well, AI going to miss that shot, but that's a story for another day.
Hey, man. There will be no besmirching Allen Iverson on this.
We talk
podcast.
About goats here. We not don't bring AI in the conversation.
Well,
that's all I'm saying.
I just thought about killers. I mean, but my point in saying that is that you're right. He will make the smart basketball play. The smart basketball play is to pass the ball to the little guy.
Man,
in the
it's
corner.
Three guys on me.
But
it's two guys
Jordan's
open.
Jordan's not going to do that.
Exactly, and LeBron
gets
the knock.
Not gonna do that.
And that's what y'all knock him for making the smart basketball play.
Knock him.
I'm just saying people say he's soft or he doesn't have that killer mentality. Like,
he does.
What's wrong? I'm a point guard by heart. Like, LeBron is just, he wants to get everybody involved. So if I got three guys on me, I see you opening it, and you don't hit the shot, how is that on me? Oh, LeBron should have took that shot. Why? I had three guys on me. It doesn't make sense.
Jern, if we go down, you've been here before. We go to Run and Shoot.
Okay.
You remember Run and Shoot, right?
Oh, yes.
In Atlanta. Let's go to Run and Shoot. We're going to Run and Shoot and we picking teams. You picking LeBron or Jordan first?
LeBron.
Okay.
He's the size of Karl Malone. He fast is the fastest guy. LeBron is he's a mutant. Like, you can't find that. Michael Jordan wasn't a mutant. Like, I'm serious. I mean, LeBron is 6'8", 260, 70 pounds.
You pick LeBron and I'll pick Jordan and y'all will be waiting.
We're going to run y'all. Give me Kyle. I'm shutting him down. I got faith in LeBron shutting Jordan
all
down.
All I'm going to do is stand in the corner and wait for Mike to pass it to me. And I'm going to be just like Paxson. I'm going to be just like Kerr. I'm not going to miss. That's all. So before we get out of here, man, go ahead and make your final case for why you think LeBron Tramone James is the GOAT.
Okay. The reason why I think he's the GOAT, A, you want to talk numbers? He's got the numbers. He's got to the championship. Yes, he's 4-6 in the finals, but I say.
But he got the numbers, though.
The quest of him, 10 finals is an accomplishment. You getting there is more of achievement than you winning, going 6-0 when you're facing bums in the finals. Like, who was the guy? They played the Lakers, the no-showtime Lakers. They weren't even the real Lakers they played the first time, so you didn't really beat Magic. Then you played the Blazers. Then you played the Suns. The Suns team y'all played, legit. I give you that one. The Blazers team was legit. I give you that one. But then the rest of them, the Sonics and the Jazz the last two times, nah. Michael Jordan winning all of them easily. But anyway, Jordan would have not beat the Warriors. He would have not beat one of them Spurs teams. Heck, he wouldn't have beat the Warriors.
Well, hell, LeBron didn't beat him either.
Is LeBron beat one? He beat him once. He beat the 73-9, the greatest Warriors team, the greatest team in NBA history. But I mean, listen, he didn't have his whole complement of players. He had bums like Kyrie Irving, bums like Kevin Love, bums like Tristan Thompson. It is hard, and these guys not showing up, and you got to carry the load. But, hey, LeBron can do that because them shoulders are big enough. You know what I'm saying? Then he thrived in the era where the internet is prevalent. He wasn't able to say, hey, I only talked to Peter Vesey and Ahmad Rashad. Them the only two people I talked to.
No, it was just Ahmad. Look,
just Ahmad. See, that mean just think Ahmad. If LeBron came out right now and said, you know, the only guy I talked to is Stephen A. Smith. They wouldn't have it. LeBron is in the locker room with his teammates. Jordan had his own locker room. Yeah, because nobody wanted to talk to the rest of the bums on the team. So they were just like, look, he got 60 reporters around him. Nobody's over there talking to Scotty. You know what I'm saying? You know, nobody cared. So LeBron thrived in the era with the internet. No scandal, scandal-free. We don't have stories about LeBron going to gamble on a game night, going to a whole nother state over to gamble, and then next thing you know, have a bad game the next day. We don't hear even the propaganda about Michael Jordan, the flu game is in question. We don't know if it was the flu,
he was drunk, food poisoning,
hungover. We don't know. It's stories that he flew from Utah to Vegas on a night. Come on, man. Mm-hmm. Now, listen, that was one of the greatest performances I've ever watched in my life. It made a tear come out of my eye because, I'm that much of a Bull fan. You know what I'm saying? That night right there, I thought I was seeing something magical, but as I got older and see Jordan was just a drunk, and it ruined the story for me. But we don't have those stories with LeBron. Yes, LeBron caught cramps. Yes, LeBron
disappeared. Oh, I forgot about the cramps.
Yes, LeBron disappeared in the fourth quarter in the series. Yes, Dirk Nowitzki should not have a title. Jason Kidd should not have a title. Yes, that is
Jason
true.
Terry has a title.
Jason Terry has a title. What was that little guy named? The one that Barboza or something like that?
Yeah. Little dude.
Little guy.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Should not have a title. So listen. So yes, LeBron did let a couple of people get rings in his era, but there's nothing he could do about that. You can't beat them all. I wish LeBron played in the 90s so he could just erase this. Because, listen, it was a guy out there to play for the Hawks named Dominique Wilkins.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
He gave Jordan a run for his money. The only thing Dominique didn't do was win when it counted. But athletically, statistically, he was right there with Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan even said himself Dominique was a better player than him. So if Michael Jordan said Dominique was better than him, I got to believe LeBron better than Dominique. And them coming out of Michael Jordan's mouth, I rest my case. LeBron's the GOAT.
What's funny, man? I like how in your little diatribe right there, you said he beat the 73-9 Warriors, but then he didn't have enough help to get smoked by him the next 2 years after that. Again, man,
one of the greatest players of all time.
I love LeBron, man. I love LeBron, man, but he's not number one. He's at two. And I'll be honest, King Jerm, I just started putting him at two because for a while, I mean, he had to overcome Irvin, Magic Johnson, and Kareem and all of those other guys. And I always ask people, and nobody can give me a definitive answer as to when this happened, but when did LeBron get better than Kobe? I mean, you don't have to answer that. That's just a rhetorical question for the listeners. Maybe somebody will hit me up and tell me.
2014, when Kobe got hurt, when he got hurt.
Must have been when he retired. But yeah, man, my case for Jordan is quite simple, man. He is the GOAT. I laid it out here. Unlike my friend over there, I don't have to make up stuff. I don't have to kind of tweak the stats. I don't have to juice the stats or juice the line or anything. No, and I said it at the beginning. He's not the type of person you want to hang out with. He was the one that you wanted to watch. Here's the thing that I'll say about Jordan for those of you who didn't grow up in the 90s. Jordan was the guy who made your mom or your grandma watch basketball if they never watched before. You would tune in for that. You would tune in to see MJ play. You tune in to see Black Jesus. You tune in to see the Black Cat, whatever you want to call him. Yeah, so that's the thing that you don't understand about Jordan. He was that guy that was going to make people tune in to see, and you know it was going to be a show when you tuned in. Again, I could easily say, yeah, six rings is better than four. I mean, we know that. I'm not even going to touch. As you know, I ain't really even talk about the rings and the dominance.
Because that's a team accomplishment.
It's well, I mean, individual. But I just told you he didn't play with anybody. So, I mean, you could say team all you want, but LeBron can't say I beat the team of the 73-9 Warriors, and then you can't give Jordan credit for winning six rings. You can't have it both ways, Jerm. That's what y'all do. That's what y'all do all the time.
But LeBron in that game, what was his stat line in that game? Like 40-some point. He did every. Come on, man. LeBron
But he still got the L, bro. That's all that matters. No, wins and losses.
Oh, you're talking about after the 73.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, okay. It's still wins and losses. Still wins and losses. True. And again, I don't want to hear anything. He disappeared in game four against Dallas. And because he disappeared, Jason Terry, who talked mad shit to LeBron during that series, has a ring. And if you ever want to see a man melt into mush, go watch that game. He was mush the whole game. But anyway, man, again, Jordan, he's the guy. He's the one. He's the GOAT. I mean, LeBron, he's close, man. And you know what, Jerm? And I'll say this to you and all of the listeners. There's nothing wrong with being number two. Especially if you're behind the GOAT, there's nothing wrong with being number two. Now, you know, I know Ricky Bobby famously said, if you ain't first, you last. But in this case, it's okay to be number two. And my last question for my man King Jerm before we sign off here. Jerm, I'm going to ask you this question.
Okay.
If your life was on the line and you had one man to play for your life, the Taliban got you. Hey, let's just say the Taliban got you and they got you tied up and they got a gun to your head and they say, okay, Jerm, we about to play this game and you need to have somebody play for you for your life. Who you going to put on the court? You going to put Jordan out there or LeBron?
Oof. I mean.
One game, not a series, one game. Your life is on the line.
Give me LeBron. I got faith in LeBron. I can't sit here and change up now. I sat there and talked to the whole people. You set me up. You thought you were going to sit here and talk to me and then get me to say Michael Jordan? No, I'm sticking with LeBron. I got faith LeBron can score any. Listen, LeBron can score anytime he wants to. You know that, right? I mean, all he has to do is go to the basket. He doesn't get all the calls that he's supposed to get because he's a big guy. And so LeBron should actually have at least 18, 19 free throws a game. He gets hacked on every play. It's like they hack him like Shaq, but they're like, oh, he's big. That's not really a hack. But a little guy, he gets that call. But at any rate, I'm taking LeBron if I got one game for my life. Give me LeBron, man.
Hey, man.
I don't know if Jordan had been drinking the night before.
I'm going to let you in a little secret, Jerm. If you got LeBron to play for your life, you a dead motherfucker. Mm.
But like I said, you don't know if you're going to get a hungover, Jordan. Are you thinking about that parlay he got?
If the stakes is high and Jordan got to play for my life, hey, I'm putting it in his hands. LeBron, I'm not. No, there's no way I'm putting it in LeBron's hands.
Faith in the King.
Yeah. Well, you know what? I will be singing Gangsta Lean at your funeral.
Gotta have faith, Kyle. That's what I'm saying. Hey,
you know what? I just because you're my man, I'll check in on the queen. You know, check it. I'll do some podcasts with her from time to time, man. You know, I'll set up a little scholarship fund for your kids. You know, particularly if they go to HBCUs, particularly if they go to South Carolina State, I might pay their whole tuition.
Wow. Y'all heard what he said now. Y'all heard what he said. I told y'all, it's no myth. Earthquake say, these ain't jokes.
But Jerm ain't going to make it if LeBron got to play for his life. I'm going with Jordan. But ladies and gentlemen, we definitely appreciate you guys listening. Jerm, before we get out of here, man, tell folks where they can find you, how they can check out the podcast.
Hey, man, you can find us every Friday, man. We drop the Frocast. You can go to frocast.com. You can go to any DSP We on all of them. Find us on Twitter at Frocast. Find us on Twitter is The Frocast. Instagram mm-hmm. is Frocast. So just follow us, man. Check us out. Hope you like the show, man.
Oh, for sure, for sure. You guys know where to find me and know where to find this podcast. You've been listening to this long. The 12 Kyle podcast drops every Thursday at midnight. And from time to time, we will drop bonus episodes on Sundays at midnight. You can catch me at 12 Kyle on all the socials. Like I said, LeBron versus MJ. I mean, this is GOAT talk. I mean, yeah. it's we know it's semantics. It's Mercedes-Benz versus BMW. It's Prince versus Stevie Wonder. In conclusion.
Usually Prince goes against Michael Jordan. I mean, excuse me, Michael Jackson.
I mean, well, you know, Michael Jackson ain't the musician that Stevie is. So that goes.
Okay, you just talking about
and we already know that we already know that Purple Rain's better than Thriller, but that's another story for another day. In conclusion, LeBron James.
You started some shit.
LeBron James. All around, statistically, will be like I said earlier.
He already got better stats than Michael.
Be there when it's well, not all stats. Some of the stats are not gonna happen, and he'll never get a scoring average. And he's not gonna catch him in rings. We already see that right now because this team right now they might not even make the playoffs.
Question, but that's another. If LeBron was 6-4, would that change your stance?
It depends on how he did the 6-4, but if he did the 6-4, he's there. I'll be honest, Jerm, for me, LeBron is a very close second. It ain't even really about championships for me. I mean, if he had a fifth championship, I could make a case. Now, granted, there are some people, you know, particularly like our children, who all they've seen is LeBron. So like my sons, they've seen tapes of Jordan because I make them watch tapes. But like, you know, if someone said, hey, LeBron is the best player I've ever seen, then I'm not going to argue that with you because that's all you've seen. But for somebody that's 43 years old that should know better, I got to school them.
I mean, I'm just saying. I'm able to put my bias to side.
I am too.
But y'all Jordan, too. Like I said, y'all Jordan fans, y'all will not let him lose. And I admire it. And it's just, you know, we holding on a piece of our childhood. I get it. I was just first to let go and be like, listen, it's okay. Like, it's life after Jordan.
Like I said, statistically, he's there, you know, but Jordan was a better scorer. And, you know, Mike won on the biggest stage and he beat some of the greatest opponents. LeBron he's had better teammates. And, you know, Mike played in a league that wasn't as athletic as LeBron is. And LeBron played in a weaker conference the majority of his career. So, who's the GOAT? Who knows? Jerm says it's LeBron. I say it's Jordan.
GOAT is Phil Jackson because Kobe or Jordan ain't got no rings without Phil Jackson. But hey, that's another Phil ain't story got no rings for another day.
Either, so yeah,
I mean, true.
But the one way we could settle all of this is that if there's one of you, you know, brains out there that's listening, somebody can create a time machine. Let us jump back in time and we go back and make it happen on the court. So that's gonna do it for us. So for my man King Jerm, I'm your boy 12 Kyle. We'll catch you guys next time. 5 G's.